State of Truth AM, live and uncensored. Okay, I want to talk to you about seismology, about earthquakes, right? If you know anything about how the Earth works, you know that where two tectonic plates meet, there's earthquake activity there, okay? They push against each other, and when the pressure gets too high, there's what they call a seismic shift. That's an earthquake. We know this. That's how it happens wherever you are in the world. Japan, Chile, California, it's all the same. Or is it? What about the Merida earthquake we had back in March? What do you know about that? Well, I'll tell you what I know. I know that the nearest fault line is hundreds of miles away, where the Caribbean plate meets the North American plate. You know what else I know? That there is no way a 9.8 earthquake is going to register at the epicenter location they're giving us. It's not on the fault line, and it certainly isn't close enough to one to register a 9.8. So you have to ask yourself, what's going on here? How is the biggest earthquake in recorded history occurring in a location with minimal seismic activity? How is it that this so-called earthquake just happens to open up a new vein of mineral and ore-rich deposits that the Mexican government can sell off to the highest bidder? I mean, listen to me on this. There is now more iridium around Merida than anywhere else on Earth. And I'm telling you, the single most valuable material on Earth right now is iridium. The earthquake couldn't have happened at a better time. It's so perfect. It almost seems like it was supposed to happen, right? What I'm telling you is that this was not a natural disaster. This was a planned and well-executed operation. Now, who planned it and how they did it is still under investigation, but there's a lot of people looking at this right now. The people need to know who has the power, the energy needed to create a massive seismic shift. The government? Private enterprise? Were the Santonian Mining Company involved? We know they benefited, right? They got the contract just a few months after the iridium was found. Contracts like that take years, not months. Look, I don't have all the answers, but I know the questions we, you, need to be asking. So that's the topic for tonight. Why was there an earthquake? Who or what caused it? And who benefits? All right, lines are open. Who's